Hi students, let us continue with the automatic repeat request. So in the previous video, I just explained the simple stop and wait method. So what are the problems that simple stop and wait error mechanism is facing? How those problems will be rectified by using automatic repeat request? Let's see. So the lost data and the lost acknowledgement, delayed acknowledgement or data problems are resolved by stop and wait automatic repeat request. So which does both the error control and flow control. So it will do both. It is not only performing the operation of error control and it also do work on flow control. So the stop and wait ARQ, it's a considering of simple stop and wait. It follows the rules of simple stop and wait and timeout. The timeout, whenever the lost data is, if there is a lost data, it indicates with a timeout. Okay, timeout will be indicating that a lost data is lost. And the sequence number for the data, why we are giving the sequence number for the data? To know the acknowledgement. So, for what data we are receiving the acknowledgement. Okay. And the sequence number for the acknowledgement. So, why we are giving the sequence number for the acknowledgement? To overcome the delayed acknowledgement. So, actually these three are the problems for this stop and wait. Simple stop and wait. Lost data, lost acknowledgement, delayed acknowledgement or data. So to overcome those problems, what this simple stop and wait ARQ is doing, it is seeing the concepts of, introduce the concept of timeout, sequence numbers for data, it is giving the sequence numbers for the data and it also gives a sequence number for the acknowledgement. Okay, so stop and wait automatic repeat request has to follow the rules of stop and wait. At the same time, it has to give the timing for the each frame, each data, and it has to give the sequence number for whatever the data it is sending, 1, 2, 3, like that, and the acknowledgement for that particular data, the sequence number for that particular data. Okay, so this, with the help of timeout, we can overcome the problem of lost data. With the help of the sequence number data, we can overcome the problem of lost acknowledgement, and delayed acknowledgement can be overcome by using sequence number acknowledge. So now let's see what is the concept of timeout in this timeout. Okay, so in the timeout, let's take here the sender was there and the receiver was there. Sender and the receiver. So now sender is sending the data. Suppose before reaching the receiver side, the data was lost. So we are discussing about the lost data. So for to overcome this lost data, we are using the timeout. So sender sends the data. Before receiving the receiver, the data was lost. So what the sender will do? The sender will wait for a particular time. Whenever the timeout is there, so whenever it waits for only 2 minutes or 5 minutes, so it's wait for 2 minutes. So after 2 minutes, the sender may think that, okay, data was lost. What I had to do? I'll again send the data. So after receiving the receiver will send the acknowledgement. So by using the time of concept, this lost data concept problem will be resolved. How it is resolved? The sender has to wait only for the particular time. Whenever the time is out, okay, if 2 minutes is over, the sender will again send the same data to the receiver. Okay, so next is sequence number for the data. Why we are giving sequence number for the data? Sequence number for data. So we are giving the sequence number for data for lost acknowledgement. Suppose if there is any lost acknowledgement. So how we overcome this lost acknowledgement? Here the sender was there and the receiver is there. Okay. The sender sends the data. Data 1. We are giving the sequence number for the data, whatever it is sending. The sender sends the data 1. So, here the receiver sends the acknowledgement to the sender that the receiver has received the data 1 and consume it. So, it is sending the acknowledgement. Before reaching the sender, the acknowledgement will be lost. That is lost acknowledgement. So, what it does in a particular time? Okay. In a particular time, if the time is out, the sender, what it does? It again sends the data 1, because the sender doesn't receive the acknowledgement for the data 1, so again it sends the data 1. So whenever it sends the data 1, if it receives, it sends the acknowledgement. Okay, so this can overcome the problem of lost acknowledgement. Whenever the lost acknowledgement is lost, the sender will again sends the data 1. Okay. So, now the sender is not able to, I mean, it is not in the confusion state, because by clearly it knows that data 1 is lost. Means data 1 is not received, or the receiver is not able to cache the data. So, that's why I didn't receive the acknowledgement. So, again it will send the data 1. So, here the data 1 consumed and acknowledgement is sent. Okay, but the receiver sends acknowledgement, okay, instead of negative acknowledge, because of sequence number attached to sender packet. Now let's see the third concept. So what is the third one? Delayed acknowledge. So delayed acknowledge, this is resolved by introducing the sequence number for acknowledgement also. By introducing sequence number for acknowledgement also. So here the delayed acknowledgement can also be solved by using the sequence number. So whenever the data 1 is sent, the acknowledgement 1, it has to be sent back. Data 2, acknowledgement 2. So that there is no confusion for the sender as well as the receiver, which data is received and which data is acknowledged. Okay, now let's see a simple concept working of stop and wait ARQ, how it is going to be worked. Let me explain by using these three concepts, the timeout and the sequence numbers for the acknowledgement and sequence number for the data. Let's see a simple example for this stop and wait. So here the A was there and B was there, the sender A and sender B. So the sender A sends the data frame or a packet with sequence number. So I am sending data or a frame with sequence number. Suppose let's send data 0. The receiver B, after receiving the data frame, it sends an acknowledgement with sequence number. So it is sending with sequence number. Okay, I received data 0 and I acknowledged. Okay, the acknowledgement data 0 and first acknowledgement data 1. Okay, after that it's again the sender sends the data 1. Okay, so whenever it sends the data 1, it will be acknowledged. Okay, so here there is only one bit sequence number, that implies that both sender and receiver have buffer for one frame or a packet only. So suppose here at this time It's sending another frame, another data. Let's take data 0. It was lost. Okay, after sending again the data 0, it was lost. So then what next? Here the sender has to wait for a particular time. And again it sends the data 0. How much time it waits? It until the time is out. Time out. So whenever the time is out, the frame lost or data lost, frame or data lost, it retransmits the data. So whenever it receives the acknowledgement, it sends another data. The sender again sends the another data. So before, after sending, the sender has to wait until it receives the acknowledgement. But it doesn't receive any acknowledgement from the receiver. So he thought that the data may be lost. So after a particular time is out, the data again, the sender will be sends the data 0. That is a retransmission. So whenever it receives that retransmission, it sends the acknowledgement. Okay, so again it is sending another data, data 1. So this time acknowledgement was lost. Let us take the acknowledgement was lost. So what it does, so the sender has to wait particular time. So whenever it sends the data, it waits until it receives the acknowledgement. Okay, it doesn't receive any acknowledgements at a particular time, means the timeout. So acknowledgement is lost. So what it does, it again retransmits. So the sender has to do everything. The receiver will be just simply constant. It just take the data and sends the acknowledgement. That's it. The sender has to retransmit the data whenever it receives, doesn't receive the acknowledgement. If the acknowledgement is lost or data is lost, the sender has to retransmit. So again it retransmits the data. So next time it receives the acknowledgement. Okay, so this is the concept of stop and wait ARQ, stop and wait automatic repeat request. So in this stop and wait automatic repeat request, you are having the concept of simple stop and wait. You have to follow the rules of simple stop and wait and timeout, sequence numbers for the data, sequence numbers for the acknowledgement. If you follow these three rules, then the data can be sent within a particular time. Then what are the advantages of this stop and wait? Advantages. The advantage of this stop and wait ARQ is it can be used for noisy channels. It can be used for the noisy channels. And it has both flow and error control mechanism. Flow and error control mechanisms. And it has timer implementation. That is the main important thing. It is have timer implementation. So with the help of the timer implementation only, we can overcome the problems of the simple stop and wait. Next, what are the disadvantages? So still they are having disadvantages in this simple stop and wait ARQ. The first disadvantage is efficiency is very less. Efficiency is very less. Why it is very less? Because at a time the sender can send only one data packet. Okay, the sender is not able, no concept of sending all the packets at a time. So until it receives the acknowledgement, it has to send the same packet. Okay, so that's why efficiency is very less. And only one frame is sent at a time. Only one frame or data is sent at a time. So here the timer should be sent for each individual frame. For each frame, the timer has to be sent. So these are the disadvantages of stop and wait ARQ. So to overcome these disadvantages of stop and wait ARQ, we will go for the sliding window protocol. Thank you.